We've hit the ground. This is Korriban. Why would one of the Jedi you're looking for come here?
It seems quiet. Just the wind. But deep beneath the surface, you can feel the pain of what took place here. There's great power in this place, for those who can hear its call.
There is much that would draw a Jedi to this place. The resting grounds of the ancient, and more recently departed Sith, contain many teachings believed lost. The most likely place to find our lost Jedi is the ruins of the old academy. It was said that Revan intended to return to Korriban to subdue any potential Sith insurgents, but Revan disappeared. It took a year or two for the Republic to send a force here to deal with any Sith that may have remained. They found Korriban much as we have, barren and lifeless. It was assumed that the remnants of the Sith turned on each other, vying for what little power remained. The Republic found evidence that several Sith Lords escaped Korriban, fleeing to remote sections of the galaxy. As lifeless as it seems, the dark side is very strong here. The Sith Lords would not ignore such a powerful place. There is much that can be learned, even here. If you walk Korriban's surface, you shall walk it without me. I cannot. This place is strong with the dark side. It is difficult to center myself here. Korriban holds few secrets from me, but much that you should learn. Remain here and meditate. Our link remains. I shall contact you and provide guidance when needed. The academy is on the other side of this valley. Be careful. Dark energy fills these ruins, and even the fallen Sith live still. The structures you see around you are the plundered tombs of the ancient Sith Lords. Each tomb was once infused with the history and heritage of the old Sith Empire, containing great mysteries and powerful relics of the Force. However, even the many traps could not long hold back the curious, the fools, and the weak. And so these tombs fell, spilling their secrets into the hands of those unable to comprehend or preserve them. The broken corpses before you are all that remain of the Sith on Korriban. I doubt there is much to be gained from looting these bodies. It would be best to leave them be. Sent their guardians. Hissis are semi-intelligent beasts, corrupted and strengthened by prolonged exposure to the dark side. As creatures of the Force, they have a limited ability to mask their presence. Hissis are drawn to suffering and carnage. They must have fed on all the corpses left over from the war here on Korriban. The angry phantoms of the Sith, too weak to influence the sentient, have taken these hisses as thralls to their will. Here, you can just barely see the Sith archaeologists' efforts to uncover relics of the ancients. The new Sith Order sought to progress quickly by finding objects of power. I can only imagine what was lost forever due to the carelessness of these excavators. Now the excavation has been almost completely undone by 5 years of wind and sand. So does Korriban protect its secrets. This way leads to the tomb of Ajunta Paul, a fierce Sith Lord. According to legend, the blade proved more fearsome than the master, leading to his demise. Ajunta's dark specter lived on through the centuries until Revan entered the Sith Lord's tomb in search of the blade. Revan calmed the angry ghost of Ajunta Paul and showed him the path back to the light. Unknown. Some have suggested that the blade led to Revan's demise, as it did Ajunta Paul. That is only speculation, however. Where Revan wanders now is knowledge that only Revan owns. Before you is the tomb of the great Sith Lord, Marc Aragnos, a half-breed who possessed tremendous strength, both physically and in the Force. Ragnos held power for over a century, using his cunning to turn his enemies against each other. His death left a great vacuum of power. We're standing close to the spot where Naga Sadal first confronted Ludo Kresh to vie for domination of the Sith. Their struggle nearly resulted in a civil war that would have torn the Sith apart before they ever threatened the Republic. Yes, it is the way of the Sith. They must continually test their strength against each other, even if it means destroying themselves. As fate would have it, a pair of hyperspace explorers from Sinagar landed on Korriban. Naga Sadal manipulated the Sith into believing they were a sign of impending Republic invasion. This fear resonated with many Sith who were discontent with the lack of expansion of the Sith Empire during the reign of Marc Aragnos. Thus, Naga Sadal became Ragnos' successor.
Smell that? It's the scent of death and overpopulated beasts coming from that cave.
Listen. The wind from the cave tells of great power within. Recently awakened.
There is great power and dark energy within this cave. I would advise you to finish your explorations within the Academy before venturing into the cave.
This door was left open on purpose. Someone is expecting us.
This looks like a trap if ever I've seen one.
You can expect more than these beasts within the Academy. Be prepared.
Apprentice is here. Find him.
Thank you. Thank you.
A dark Jedi left her impression here. This door has been sealed intentionally.
Thank you.
This Jedi's death shortly after we arrived on Korriban.
Did you come here for answers? There are none. The call of Korriban is strong, but it is the call of the dead. It is fitting you came here. I have studied you and found nothing but weakness. Yet still she clutches at you as if you are all that gives her life. I know her as an apprentice knows their master, and as a master knows an apprentice. I want her to die and see all that she has built cast down, all that she holds dear in shards at her feet. She clings to hope that perhaps she can train one as great as her first. She is a fool who escaped death once. She will not do so again. But you do not know her as I do. You have not survived her teachings as I have. And you have not bested her in battle as I have. You are nothing. Yet still she walks with you. Is willing to sacrifice herself for you. I have studied you. I know the paths you walked in exile. I know your teacher. I know the fires that raged upon the Ducks and Moon while the Republic died around you. You know war. You know battle. And I know of Malachor. You saw the heart of war, what Malachor wrought. Yet you turned away from it. You are a wretched thing. A thing of weakness and fear. You are her apprentice in name only. I am the master. And that is why you will die.
Be another time, but it is not now, not here, while Korriban runs through him.
She protects him, shields him. Find him, hunt him wherever he travels. He will not escape me again. I will bring his corpse to her, cast it at her feet. It will be as if killing her children. I will kill all she protects, all she shields, until her hands are drenched in blood.